then today we are going to revise all the chapters in the form of MCQs. I'll ask you questions and you people will be giving up the answers, okay? Because today you are having a revision test.
Yes.
Okay, so I want that all the syllabus of revision test to be revised. Huh? Yes, options I'll give. I'll give the options. Yes, the first one is, suppose a passage is given and an extract is given to you. You can see up in your books. Not a leaf remained on the trees. The corn was totally destroyed. The flowers were gone from the plants. Lencho's soul was filled with sadness. When the storm had passed, he stood in the middle of the field and said to his sons that a plague of locusts would have left more than this. And the hail has left nothing, and this year we will have no corn. That night it was a sorrowful one. All our work for nothing. There's no one who can help us. We will all go hungry this year, he was thinking. So now the question is, Lencho's crops were destroyed by who? What has destroyed his crops? Strong wind, droughts, locusts, or hailstones? Hailstones. Hailstones. Lencho was thinking of what? He was thinking of his past sins, his dark future, his debility, or starvation ahead. What he was thinking? I'm asking what Lencho was thinking of his past sins, of his dark future, of his starvation ahead. Of his starvation, because in the last passage, last line of the passage, it was given. He said to his son that we will all go hungry this year. Next, a plague of locusts is visualized by Lencho as what? He has visualized these plague of locusts as destructive, more destructive than the storm, more harmful than the storm, or less destructive than the storm. More destructive than the storm. Because he has, what is the reason for this answer? Because he has said that plague of locusts would have left. Sorry, plague of locusts, he has not more destructive. Keshav, he has looked that is less destructive. Less destructive. Usne socha tha? Because plague of locusts would have left more than that. It means that storm is more destructive. Okay. So, next is, in which state of mind was Lencho? What was his state of mind? He was amused, sad, optimistic, or worried? He was worried, right? What is the meaning of plague and with locusts is used in the sense of? It was highly infectious, a large number of, harmful, or highly destructive? Highly destructive. Okay. So the next question is, on seeing the ripe corn in rain, Charles Lencho felt, when he has seen his ripe corn in rain forest, how did Lencho felt? He felt excited, he felt satisfied, he felt irritated, or he felt happy? What kind of feeling he was having? When he has seen his corn in the rain showers, how he felt? When he has seen his corn field in rain showers mein usne dekha, when he has seen that now the rain is coming, rain is pouring down. So what he has felt? Excited, satisfied, irritated, happy. He had a sense of satisfaction, not happy. Happy was one, you can say, feeling that he has, but more he was satisfied. Why? Because he was satisfied with the feeling that now he will reap a rich harvest. Okay. What did the boys do in the rain? Jumped, swam in the pools of water, started collecting hailstones, or remained indoors? They were started collecting hailstones. Young boys started collecting hailstones. Yes. Third one. Next is, hailstones at first did not appear to Lencho to be shining, harmful, precious, or auspicious? At first, what he thought? No. See, at first, these hailstones did not appear. Kya nahi lage the usko? They did not appear shining, harmful, precious, or auspicious. Harmful. Harmful, he did not think that they were harmful for me in the starting. Harmful nahi lage the usko. How can shining? No. Okay, auspicious means having something pious. No. Okay, and precious? No. Hailstorm, so he knew that they will definitely cause any, you can say, damage to his crops. So one more. The postmaster's friends donated money. Why they donated money? As an act of charity, as a friendly gesture, as an obligation, or unwillingly? As a friendly gesture. The postmaster sent the money through a messenger, in an envelope, through a clerk, or through courier. Arre stop, how he has sent? He has written the letter and he has put it in envelope. He has put it in envelope. When Lancho came, he has on Sunday morning, he asked for his letter. He opened up the envelope and then he was in utter distress. Why? Because this did not contain 100 pesos that he asked, but what it contained? It contained only 70 pesos. See, next. The postmaster made efforts to raise money. Half-heartedly he did this? Sincerely? Spiritedly or willingly? Willingly, of course, he was willing, but it was spiritedly. He has some spirit behind this to work upon. Next, what impression do you form of the postmaster from these lines? He was helpful, insincere, indifferent, or determined? Helpful he was, but he was determined also. Determined also he was to help him. Because he thought that this kind of, you can say, this the belief of this kind of man should not be shaken at all. Okay. Next is from Nelson Mandela. I'm going to ask. Yes, first one is, who is the narrator in the chapter? Who is the narrator in the chapter, Nelson Mandela? It was a patriot, Nelson Mandela himself, Zenani, or Oliver Tambo. Stop it now. It was spoken by Nelson Mandela himself. He said that my daughter Zenani was with me. Keshav, what happened to you? And we have revised those chapters in the class. Next. What happens as a result of oppression? What happened? Gloominess, depression, birth of great men, or cheerfulness? What happens as a result of oppression? What happened? Gloominess. What is the meaning of gloominess? Sadness. Depression, cheerfulness, or birth of great men? Birth of great men, because these kind of great men has been produced because of the type of oppression they have undergone. This we have also read. Next is, people of fine character are pearls, diamonds, rubies, priceless, right? Now, my country here refers to England, Kenya, Africa, South Africa. Where does Nelson Mandela took the oath? Tell me. South Africa. Then how you are saying it's England? It's very silly answer it is. Next. The narrator is quite South Africa. I have spoken again and again while I was revising. This is against the apartheid policy that was prevalent in South Africa. Number of times I have spoken South Africa, still you are saying, ma'am, England. Kenya? That's very bad again. Astonishing. Next, the narrator is quiet, proud, humble, poor, or intellectual. The narrator is what kind? What is narrator? He was proud. Who is narrator, first of all? Nelson Mandela. Now tell me, he was proud, he was humble, poor, or intellectual? Intellectual. Why he is humble, first of all, tell me you. Why he is humble? To be humble is down to earth. He was a criminal, at that time considered criminal by the government, though he was fighting for a cause. How can he be humble? Whatever you are saying, first of all, analyze it. Whether what you are saying is right or not. Next is, the life they had leading was disturbing, happy, restless, full of indignities. Right, this is right. Next, the speaker did not desire that his countrymen should be prosperous, happy, free, or enslaved. What he did not want his countrymen to be prosperous, happy, free, or enslaved. He never wanted his countrymen to be happy, enslaved. He wanted his countrymen to be happy. All the three options are absolutely wrong. Only one is right. Next, what was the narrator's profession? Okay, Simar, tell me, what was narrator's profession? Medicine, law, teaching, politics. What was narrator's profession? Medicine, law, teaching, or politics? By profession, he was law-abiding attorney, means law. By profession, he was a lawyer. Nelson Mandela. Lawyer he was. So his profession was law. Sit down. What made him a criminal? So why? Now listen carefully. Why Nelson Mandela turned a criminal? His love for freedom, his revolt against serfdom, his love for money, his love for name and fame. His love for freedom. Of course, he wanted freedom not only for himself, but for the people of his country. Why? Because he knew that until his countrymen are in shackles, they are in chains, he would not be free. So he has a changed definition of freedom. Next, the word animated. What is the meaning of animated? Made, depressed, changed, or energized? Energized, right. Apartheid affected him and his countrymen. How apartheid affected his countrymen? Grievously, seriously, casually, or superficially? Huh? Grievously. It has produces grief. Now see, these are of, you can say, higher order thinking answers, okay? So now here you need to analyze, you need to understand. See, grievously is also is the right answer. But you will feel seriously, wo bhi galat nahi hai. Okay, all of these options will never you get. This you will never get. Okay, and superficially means on the surface only. No, this was not wrong, right. Casually, this was wrong. So out of, so first of all, try to create which are the options are correct. Now you have out of these four, you have just two options in front of you, you think. Grievously and seriously, because casually wrong ho gaya, four mein se, and superficially is also wrong. So now you are left with two options, grievously and seriously. Grievously, grieve. Grievously, because they were suffering also. So this is the reason why it is grievously. Next. The unintended effect of oppression was, what was the effect of population? Oh, sorry, effect of oppression. Chilling party, exploitation, starvation, the rise of great personalities. Chilling poverty, nowhere in the chapter we have read about it. कहीं पे भी इसका mention नहीं है. Then exploitation, yes, this is also can be one answer. Next is starvation. He said in his speech that he will never let his people starve. Okay, but otherwise nothing is there. D, it is right of great personalities, right? Next is the narrator feels that even oppression, okay, is tolerable, is long, has its own advantage or is good. Ab batao, that oppression, the narrator feels that oppression, you understand oppression now? The person who oppresses other is tolerable. First of all, tell me yes or no. No. Is long? Is short? We don't have any opinion about it. So ye bhi reject ho gaya. Next is good. Is good? No. No. Then only option left is has its own advantage. Yes. And it is also given in the chapter. It is because of the great oppression of character leads to the formulation of great man. Dono way se answer kya hai? Right. So this is how you have to find the right answer. You have to analyze. Okay, leave aside the wrong answers and find the correct one. Next one, it is extreme oppression that makes people physically strong, honest, and mentally and morally strong. Next, apartheid promotes, what it promotes? It promotes hatred in certain group, love for certain group, democratic feelings or patriotism. What is apartheid actually? What does apartheid mean? What is apartheid? Policy of apartheid. What it means? What does it mean? You people are saying, ma'am, no idea. So first of all, tell me, when I discuss the chapter, I have mentioned that what is the theme of the chapter? It is bringing into light. What is apartheid then? It's a discrimination on the basis of color. I have spoken in number of, yes, racial discrimination when people are discriminated. So this policy was prevalent in South Africa. Nelson Mandela was the one who is responsible to bring this policy to an end. Okay? There the white peoples, they were discriminating the blacks. Why? Because on the basis of only their color. This is the main thing on which this chapter is based. So next, the ceremonies relate to what said the ceremony. You know which ceremony is referred to here? Which ceremony is referred here? Which ceremony is being referred to here in this chapter? Which ceremony the writer or the narrator is talking about? Oath taking ceremony. Option, no option. I'm just testing your knowledge. Now see the question, actual question is, the ceremonies relate to independence of South Africa. What it means? This ceremony, it relates to independence of South Africa, installation of new government by the natives, or the end of the colonial rule in South Africa. Wrong, absolutely wrong. Which second one? Next, don't give me ma'am first wala, ma'am second. Give me the exact answer. Independence of South Africa. This is right. But second option is installation of new government. This is the right answer. Why? because of the first one, because of independence of South Africa, the ceremony, it signifies the formulation of a new government. He was taking oath at that time. So it was installation of new government, not independence of South Africa. Yeah? I told now you will find more than one answers to be correct. But see, first one, because of first one, this has led to the second one. First end hua, first option hai na, it is independence of South Africa. Of course, it is right. But second option is installation of new government. Out of these two, installation of new government is the right one. Because he was taking oath at that time. New government was being formulated. And in the paragraph also, he has mentioned that he has seen the helicopters, Impala jets in the sky giving a trail. This was showing their respect to the newly formulated government. These words I was speaking number of times while I was discussing the chapter. So next is, what does white supremacy refer to? What does it mean, white supremacy? See, it is union buildings, the Britishers, the oppressive colonial regime, or white people. Ab dekho. Yes, white people. This white people. Okay. But here it is also given oppressive colonial regime. It was a colonial rule. So this is more appropriate. White supremacy, of course, it is referring to white people. But they were oppressing others. And colonial regime was there. Why colonial? Because a group of people, they were oppressing the other group of people who are blacks. So this is the right answer. Okay. I'm telling you again and again, more than two options you will find correct. You have to choose the best one. So MCQs is not so easy to attempt as you people are thinking. Direct questions you won't get. Yes, you won't get direct questions. Direct to aapko aayenge nahi na. This is the reason why I was revising. Ki aap understand kar lo har chapter ke D point ko. Next is, the rainbow gathering stands for. Ab chalo ab batao. What does rainbow gathering stands for? Gathering of people from different races, people in multicolored dresses, appearance of rainbow in the sky, the dawn of new government. A part is right. It is gathering of people from different races. Okay, because he has mentioned that he was present among the multitudes of different countries. World leaders from different countries, they have gathered there. Next is, the figure of speech. What is the figure of speech used in rainbow gathering of different colors? Kya hai ye? Which figure of speech? It's a metaphor. It's simile or it's a symbol. It's a metaphor. It's simile or it's a symbol. No. What is simile? First of all, tell me, what is simile? I told number of times when we have studied the points, it is a comparison in which we use the words like or as. See, for example, as bright as sun. This is an example of simile. Or he is an apple of my eyes. Or apple of my eyes. So here I'm comparing apple of my eyes means something very precious. But here I'm using, am I using the word like or as? No, I'm not using. But still I'm making comparison. This is metaphor. They are the rainbow. So this is a metaphor. So many twisted questions are there, hai na? Ab aapko lagta hai bahut tough hai. Chalo, let me ask you. Okay, I will ask from some other chapter. You are tired of this now. What is non-racial government? What is non-racial government? Options are secular, non-secular, neutral, or atheistic. non-racial government, secular, non-secular, neutral or atheistic. Non-secular, what is secular then? If it is non-secular, what is secular? Are it is secular, we respect of each and every religion, every race. You, this you are studying in class 6. India is a secular country. Stop it now. Civics mein kyun nahi kara aapka ye starting se padhte ho? India is a sovereign country. India is a secular country, but they are talking about secular. So you must have known to the meaning of secular. Next one. Let me ask from two stories about flying. Okay to see anything outside was when the man was flying an aeroplane. I'm asking from the black aeroplane. Okay, to see anything outside was possible, impossible, difficult, easy. Impossible. He was not able to see. It was completely dark. The lights were off. Impossible. The compass was non-functional, functional, not visible or of little use. It was non-functional, it was functional, it was non-visible or of little use. What happened to compass, Keshav? First of all, tell me. What happened to compass? What happened to compass, Vineet Roop, in the chapter? Black aeroplane. No, I'm not giving option. I'm asking you what happened to compass of the narrator. Just a moment. Sit down, Kirti. Yes, what happened to compass? So, it was moving round and round. Okay, it has lost all the control of the directions. So it was non-functional, it was functional, it was not visible or of no use. Non-functional. Pata chala? But I asked the options, but still you people were not able to answer. Chalo. So the last question today's this practice is, the old aeroplane seemed to be dashed in the storm. Helpless, doing its best, helpless. Okay. Non-movement of compass was unimportant, very important, very important, bit dangerous or of great risk. Non-functioning of or non-movement of compass was unimportant, very important, bit dangerous or great risk. It is great risk. It is of great risk. Okay, last, with the compass being dead, the narrator was mad with anxiety, directionless, highly confused, totally directionless. Totally directionless. He did not know any directions. He did not know where to move. Compass hi kharab ho gayi to. Right? So this is all about revision of first two chapters. Okay? So tomorrow we will continue further. Now if you have any doubt, you can ask me.